nothing compares to you.
Thank you.
set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Place, Spirit, place. Set our hearts on fire. Oh, river, flow of the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, born and led every life. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill
show us the truest definition of faith. When you live your life preparing for the worst possible outcomes, then it's like living in a cage where there's no chance of freedom at all. As you mature as a Christian, you will learn how to recognize the difference between guarding your heart and restricting it. And only then will you be able to stop talking yourself out of the good things of God that He has promised to those who live according to His will. It is impossible to tap into this incredible power and hang on to excuses at the same time. So shedding excuses is a discipline that must be practiced with our thoughts, communications, and actions, similar to the discipline required in order to exercise or stay on a diet. Two words are important to this type of world, the words I will. The power of positivity in your own life can set you on the right path, as well as being a shining example for others. If we learn from our past experiences about what has stopped us before, and this helps us in our path forward, if your journey towards healing with God has been shaped by other people, then your journey will always require permission before progression. To put it another way, don't allow your destiny to be determined by a democracy. This last statement I feel is critical, so I'll repeat it. Don't allow your destiny to be determined by a democracy. The first step is to let go of the excuses and to vow to move forward in your journey. This is the first brick in the construction of the new you in Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 5, 6-10 shows us about being humble and having ultimate faith. So humble yourself under the mighty power of God, and at the right time, He will lift you up in honor. Give all your worries and cares to God, for He cares about you. Stay alert. Watch out for the great enemy, the devil, who prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Stand firm against him and be strong in your faith. Remember that your family of believers all over the world is going through the same kind of suffering you are. In His kindness, God called you to share His eternal glory by means of Christ Jesus. So after you have suffered a little while, He will restore, support, strengthen you, and He will place you on a firm foundation. That foundation will be made on the rock of Jesus Christ and not on the sinking sand that is found in many of life's earthly creations. There is no promise that life with God will not have any shares, your shares of trials and tribulations, but the reward in the end is so much greater. Have you ever considered what is behind your emotions and actions in everyday situations? This usually requires a lot of soul-searching to figure out what things happen in your life, and what did it teach me, but more importantly, how can I prevent it from happening again? The only way to make a change in your life is to find out the root cause of your actions and make a plan to change it. Any negative or unhappy thoughts need to be replaced by a positive, healthier one. We need to learn to lean on God in these situations because many times there are issues in our lives that we cannot handle by ourselves. He has a perfect plan and will for your life, so we just have to trust His plan. Isaiah 41:10 says, "Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand." And in Joshua 1:9, God says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." 1 Corinthians 10-13 ties back to a verse I mentioned earlier in 1 Peter 5-9, where it says, we as a family of believers experience the same types of suffering. In 1 Corinthians 10-13 it says, the temptations in your life are no different from what others experience. God is faithful. He will not allow the temptation to be more than you can stand. When you're tempted, He will show you a way out so you can endure. God is always the light at the end of the dark tunnel. Everything you need to be successful, blessed, honest, and happy in life are already there. You just need to learn how to recognize the signs and harness your thoughts and energy towards these goals. If you don't believe this, then you are probably focusing on the wrong things. Anything that makes you stop believing in yourself and these positive things is what I would call a premature thought that comes with its own set of complications, much like a premature birth. In the case of our family, our son Derek was born 16 weeks premature, weighing just under 2 pounds. Yes, there were many complications in that first year or so, but we never let that get in the way of constant prayer over what God could do in his life. God did not give Jen and I more than we could handle, although it seemed that way at times. Today he is almost 23, healthy and happy, and is getting ready to graduate from York University. Praise God for what he has accomplished in Derek's life. These days, the secular world is very materialistic, with everyone wanting the latest things. It is a vicious cycle that never really makes you happy or fulfilled. Instead of getting upset that you can't have something right now, we should try to wrap our heads around the thought that maybe God knows that we just aren't ready for it. Once you reach the destination that you set in your mind, God will help you realize that there is still more work to be done in your life. The old you is the safe you, and many people will look at this and hold you to your past mistakes, poor decisions, and are unhappy that you've changed. Maybe we should hold a memorial service for these people who believe this, because they will be missing out on the exciting journey of what lies ahead for you. So be strong enough to choose God and choose you over others that may want to drag you down with them. In Colossians 2:6-10, it summarizes our life walk with Jesus. And now, as you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord, you must continue to follow him. Let your roots grow down into him, and let your lives be built on him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth that you were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. Do not let anyone capture you with empty philosophies and high-sounding nonsense that comes from human thinking and from spiritual powers of this world, rather than from Christ. For in Christ lives all the fullness of God in the human body. So you are complete through your union with Christ, who is the head over every ruler and authority. Let us strengthen our roots in Jesus and rely on his authority to complete the work he has started in each one of us. We are all creatures of habit, and so it's much easier to do things the same way each time, rather than doing things differently or learning something new. We should all strive to be lifelong learners and not be complacent or safe in our everyday lives. This requires us to be in step with God and his word every day. In a January 5th, 2021 article by Christian author Mary Fairchild entitled, "How Does the Bible Define Faith?" she describes faith as the fuel for the Christian life. God provides believers in the faith needed to believe in him. For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. From Ephesians 2, 8, and 9. So let us strive to be more like God in every way, every day. In closing, I would like to leave you with one final thought. In our daily lives, don't settle for safe. Step out in faith.
Amen.
Final hymn, and then and I've got a benediction to do.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sure. Okay. Somebody's going to play the next